Hi, I'm Kathleen, and on May 27th, I had a balloon angioplasty of both my jugular veins and my azygos, and the results were immediate and profound. And I'd like to share with you the 28 improvements that I've noticed since I've had my liberation therapy. First of all, I have balance. I don't have balance issues at all anymore. I can stand in the shower with my eyes closed, tip my head back, and rinse the conditioner out of my hair while moving my head, and the wall, the ceiling, and the floor stay in place, and I remain situated between them all. My feet are steady and sure, and I trust them. I don't struggle with chronic fatigue. I get drowsy at nighttime, which is appropriate. And I wake up in the morning feeling refreshed. I don't have to push through that fatigue that keeps my brain from working. My friends tell me that they notice I have a different quality to my voice. It doesn't have that tremulous tone to it, and I'm much more fluent. I can think of words, and my thoughts flow a lot more easily. I can express myself quickly and with greater ease. One symptom that has disappeared, good riddance, I'm so grateful, is I had such a ugly feeling in my head every waking moment. I called it stainless steel skull or tin head. It gave me this sense of detachment and depersonalization, and it's gone. I feel like me again. This detachment that I had was such so, if I saw a sunset, I would think, oh, that is so beautiful, and that beauty used to imbue me with a sense of well-being. And now I can think about it, but I can't feel it. That's what I would think. But since the procedure, I feel it. I can access feelings of beauty and peace and joy on a visceral rather than a intellectual level. My depression is gone. I think I coped fairly well with the depression, but the key word is cope, because I would have to have strategies on a daily basis to get through the day and to deal with that crushing depression. Joyfully and gratefully, that is gone. Let's see what else. My vision. I see sharply. I can push open heavy doors. Should I drop something, I can squat to the floor easily, scoop it up, and rise to my feet without effort, without grabbing something. I don't drop things as much because my grip strength and my dexterity has improved. Colors. This is unusual, but colors are more saturated. If I look at my draperies, which are a rich rust. I see it so intensely. Before, when I would perceive color, the color would just kind of sit superficially on the top of my brain. But now when I look out at color, I perceive them. It just seeps deep into my brain. I've heard people describe this as moving from digital to HD. It's like Dorothy in The Wizard of Oz going from black and white to color. I can access my feelings. I glide upstairs, carried a laundry basket with both hands up the stairs. I can descend stairs without undue fear of falling. I can hold more than one thought in my head at a time. Before, like if I'd be working here on the computer and Michael said something to me, I'd be like, shh, ah, oh, ah, because it wouldn't stick. I would lose what he was saying. I couldn't follow what he is saying. I'd lose whatever it was I was doing. And now I can organize, I can plan, I can hold things in my head. I can do simple math. 31 and 47 equals 78. I yawn. That was a pleasant surprise. I had forgotten. I didn't realize that I had stopped yawning. The day after the procedure at nighttime, appropriately enough at bedtime, I started yawning. And I realized I hadn't yawned. I had just been chronically fatigued. I didn't get drowsy, sleepy, time to go to bed sleepy. I just was fatigued. And now I was yawning, and it is such a sweet, delicious sensation to yawn. I welcome that back into my life. This next issue isn't as easy for me to talk about because I have a little bathroom shyness, but let me tell you, I wasn't incontinent. I had the opposite problem. I had post-void residual, which meant I couldn't empty my bladder. I'm pleased to tell you I can now quite easily. While we're on the topic, I am no longer chronically constipated. And another thing that I've noticed is that I can eat without, digestion would tax me. After I ate, it felt so bad. It just was a lot of work to digest, and that's not a problem anymore. I don't have twitchy cement legs at night when I go to sleep. I can walk faster. I can twirl. I can skip. I can run, but I've only done it twice. I'm a little bit, I want to be careful. My veins, I just don't want to jar them. They seem a little bit vulnerable right now. So I can get out of a chair without looking like I'm 80 years old. I can just glide out of it, and my tinnitus has improved greatly. So, yeah, that's my I do get a hint of drop foot when I fatigue towards the end of the day. And I do fatigue at the end of the day, but I'm beginning to think most people do. That's just part of being human, is when you're awake all day, at bedtime you're tired. And so I'd like to show you my balance. One thing that has re-entered my life is, my 5-inch heels. So I do wear these. I go out dancing. And let me demonstrate for you. I'm going to get out of this chair. I'm going to glide easily up on my feet. And look at me walking backwards. And I'm turning and walking through the door while talking to you over my shoulder. A couple of twirls for you. So I can twirl, turn my head, look up. Look at this. I'm staying on my feet. I can also balance on one foot. Let's see if I. What I'm doing is I'm reaching for my foot. There it is. And I am on one foot. I'm tossing my foot up behind me, leaning forward, still in the one foot. Okay, there I am, 2 feet on the ground. Do my little happy dance, little happy dance, little happy dance. Okay, enough showing off. Sorry. I'm just so thrilled. So, to all of my liberation brothers and sisters, thank you. Thank you from the bottom of my heart for your courage. You inspired me, encouraged me, and now I'm liberated. For those of you awaiting liberation, stay strong. Contact me. I'll help you. If you'd like to take a trip to Egypt, I can help you out. So, that's it. My heart is full and overflowing. Bye.